Akhila went to a fair in her village. She wanted to enjoy rides on the giant wheel and play hoopla. Hoopla is a game in which you throw a ring on the items in the stall, and if the ring covers any object completely, you get it. And the number of times she played hoopla is half the number of the rides she played she had on a giant wheel. Now each ride cost rupees 3 and game of hoopla cost rupees 4. So if she spent 20 rupees in the fair, represent this situation algebraically and graphically. Now let us say that the number of times she played hoopla is, or let us take the second situation first. Each ride cost 3. So let us say X rides she has taken and Y hoopla game she has taken. Now 3 rupees for one game of ride and 4 rupees for one game of hoopla. So this is what amount she spent on riding, and this is what the amount she spent on the hoopla. Now when we add these two, it will be 20 rupees. This is what she has spent, 20 rupees. Now the scenario is the first one, the number of times she played hoopla, because we said that Y is hoopla. The number of times she played hoopla is half the number of times she rides on the giant wheel. So this is X by 2. X is the number of rides. Okay. So these are two equations which we can show algebraically. Now you can solve it, you cannot solve it, this is up to you. And the only thing is you have to make these two equations according to the situation being given, and then you have to show it on the graph. So what is the best way to show it on the graph? This is a solution in front of you, but I'll speak more than that. That means I'll give you some more idea that how to solve this. The first thing is, first let us take this one. And there is a solution. You can just solve it. Say y equal to x by 2 I am putting here. So it will be 3x plus, I am putting y equal to x by 2 in this place. 4 into x by 2 equal to 20. So what do we get? 2 to the 4. This is 5x. So x is equal to 20 by 5, that is 4. So when we put x equal to 4 here, what do we get? Y equal to 2. So x equal to 4 and y equal to 2. So you are getting, these are actually lines. 3x plus 4y equal to 20 is equivalent to the line like y equal to mx plus c. This is the line. So these are two straight lines, and these two straight lines, they intersect somewhere. So there may be lines which are intersecting, there may be two lines which are coincident, means they are same lines. There may be two lines which are parallel to each other. So this situation here is that these two lines intersect. So the intersection point is x equal to 4 and y equal to 2. And how to make these lines? I'll give you just an idea. This is a better method. Otherwise, we have one more method here. You just need two proper points to draw a line. So this is 20. So what you can do here is just put x equal to 0 and find the value of y. So when x equal to 0, I'm taking ordered pair. When x equal to 0, this whole will be 0. Y will be 20 by 4, that is 5. So y is 5. This is the first point. I put x equal to 0, find y, and now put y equal to 0, find x. That is where these two lines are intersecting on x and y axis. This is 3x. Now put y equal to 0. That is, this will be 0. We are trying to find out x. 4 into 0, that is 0, is 20. This will be 0. X will be equal to 20 by 3. So this is 20 by 3. Now the problem comes here is, when we put this kind of, or when we place this point of line, like I place just here 4 equal to 0, y equal to 0. Now this x is coming to be 20 by 3. The scenario is, we will not be able to point or pinpoint any proper value. That is, 20.3 is a decimal value, it will come. 6.66 something it will come. How to precisely point this? So this is not a good choice. This is always a choice. Always put x equal to 0, find y equal to 0, x, find y. This is always a good choice. But here it is not a good choice. So what will we do here? In this case, we will try to put x equal to this y equal to say 2. Let us see what do we get. Y equal to 2. So 3x plus y equal to 2 is 2 into 4 to the 8 equal to 20. Now 3x will be equal to 20 minus 8, that is 12. So x becomes 4. 12 by 3 is 4. So if we take value of y as what do we just took y equal to says 2, we get x equal to 4 or 3. This kind of value we got because I took the value as 4 to the 8. So y was 2 and x was what? This 8, 20 minus 8 is 12, 3 4 is 12, 4. So 4, 2 is another ordered pair. 0, 5 and 4, 2 are 2 points. So let us mark it here. What is 0, 5? X is 0, y is 5. So x is 0 and y is 5. So this is the first point. Then we have x equal to 4, y equal to 2. So x is equal to 4, this one, and y equal to 2, that is this one. This is another point. So make a line. This is how we make a line. And now let us go to this next one. Y equal to x by 2. So if we put x equal to 0, what do we get? Y equal to 0. So this line passes through origin. Now if I put x equal to 1 or x equal to 2, say, x equal to 2, y will be equal to 1. So these are the two points. So x equal to 2, that is this one, and y x equal to 2, that means y equal to 1, this one, this point. So this is one point and 0, 0 is another point, make a line. And you see they intersect at 4, 2. I solved it for you initially, x was 4, y was 2. So they are actually intersecting at this point. So now the next questions which are coming are exactly like this. That is why I took some time here so that you understand how to make a line, because showing it algebraically means this is only the solution. You don't have to worry about any other thing. Graphically means just take two points like this and show it like this. There is no pressure to find out the solution. You don't have to solve it. But if you solve it, it will be always better. Now Aftab tells his daughter, 7 years ago, I was 7 times as old as you were then. So let us take Aftab age as x and her daughter age as y. So Aftab is saying that 7 years ago, so both were 7 years ago, x minus 7, y minus 7. And he is saying that 7 years ago, I was 7 times as older as you. So this will be equal to 7 times. This is her daughter age 7 years ago. This is his age 7 years ago. Now after that, he is saying that 3 years from now, that is x plus 3 and y plus 3, because both will be 3 years older now, I shall be 3 times older as you. So this will be thrice her daughter age after 3 years, and his age will be thrice of daughter's age. So these are two equations which we are getting. So we said x and y are the age of Aftab 7 years ago, age of daughter 7 years ago. Now x minus 7 equal to 7 times y minus 7. This I explained you. This also I explained you. So you got two equations. X minus 7y equal to minus 42. How did we get? See, x minus 7 is equal to 7 y minus 7. Multiply them. X minus 7 will be equal to 7y minus 49. So we can bring 7 here, 7y here. X minus 7y will be equal to 7 minus 49, that is equal to minus 42. So x minus 7y equal to minus 42. The other is x plus 3 equal to 3y plus 3. We need to rearrange like this. X minus 3y will be equal to 6. Okay, these are two equations. Now there is another method which I explained you in the previous question. There is another method which we will do here. Let us put this up or write this in this form. X minus 7y equal to minus 42. What will be 7y? It will be x. If I take 7y here, 42 will be there. X plus 42. Right? What will be y? X plus 72. x plus 72, right? 42, sorry, 42 by 7. This is one equation. Now the second equation will be this one, x minus 3y equal to 6. So let me write it here. 3y will be equal to x minus 6, and y will be equal to x minus 6 by 3. Now we'll try to put x such that we get a proper value of y. That is, if I place x equal to say 0, so it will be 7, 6 of 42. So x is equal to 0, y will be equal to what? If I put 0 here, 42 plus 0 is 0, 7, 6 of 42. So we get 0, 6 as one coordinate. Then if I put x equal to say 7, but it will be higher value. Means we have to make a long x and y axis. So let us take some other value, like x equal to 3, you can take, no, you cannot take that. 45, 7, 7, 9, 7, 7 is a 49. So let us take minus 7, make it less. So 42 minus 7 is what? 35. So 7, 7, 5 is a 35. So if x is minus 7, y will be equal to 5. So these are the two points we got for this equation. Now we can draw it. How about this one? Let us put x equal to 0. So x is 0, y will be equal to what? 0 minus 6 by 3, 3 to the 6 minus 2. If you put x equal to say 6, x is 6, y will be what? 6 minus 6 is 0, y will be 0. So we have two points for this equation. These both are straight lines. So we have equation. Let us make the equation for this one first. X is 0, y is 5. So x is 0, y is, x is 0, y is 5. So this is one point. And x is minus 7, y is 5. So let us make minus 7 here. This is minus 7, y is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This point. So we have x is minus 7, y is 5. Sorry. X is minus 7, y is above. This is 5. So we have another point like this. And we have two points. Now make a line. Let us come to this one. X is 0, y is minus 2. So x is 0, y is minus 2. When we put x equal to 0, y equal to minus 2, this is minus 2, x is 0, so this is one point. Then x is 6, y is 0. So x is 6 means come here and y is 0. These are two points. See, we got these two points. These are called x abscissa and ordinate. That is the x-axis and y-axis, because we are getting 1, 0 and other some value. So we can make a line. So this is how we are going to, these two methods I explain to you. First, we can do it by this method, right? Or we can do it by this method also. Put a y equal to certain value, make y on the left hand side, other on the right hand side, and try to put certain values so that you get easy values to point, and you need at least or just two values to make a line. Now the path of a train A is given by 3x plus 4y minus 12. And the path of another train is given by this. Represent the situation graphically. Now here there is one situation. The situation is very clear that we have 3x plus 4y minus 12. And just witness what I am going to do with this. 6x plus 8y minus 48. Let me bring this on one side, this on another side. So I'll make it as 3x plus 4y equal to 12, and I'm taking 2 common from here, right? So it will become 2, 3x plus 4y minus 24 equal to 0. So divide both sides by 0, 2 will go. It will be essentially 3x plus 4y equal to, now this was 24, let me take it on the right hand side. Now see, this is A1, this is A2, this is B1, this is B2, this is C1, this is C2. So A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2. That is 3 by 3 is equal to 4 by 4. 1. Both are 1. And that is not equal to C1 by C2. That means these two lines are parallel. These two lines are parallel. When these two are same, that means we will not get any solution for these two equations. Solution means intersecting point. And when these two lines are, say, if I subtract these two, minus, minus, minus. So this will go, this will go, this will be 12 minus 24, that is minus 12, minus 12, and this will be 0. So 0 equal to minus 12, that is undefined. So you will see that this is not possible. You cannot find any intersection point between them. That means these two lines will never intersect. And this is shown by the equation also, which we use, or the ratio which we use to check whether these lines are parallel or not. So here the case is these two lines are parallel. And in order to find the value, just put x equal to 0, find y for this one. Again, for x equal to 0, find y. And for y equal to 0, find x. So these are two lines. See, these are two lines. So there is no point of intersection. Okay, there is no point of intersection. Because if the lines are like this, 3x plus 4y minus 12 and 6x plus 8y minus, it's not going to intersect. So just forget all this. Just concentrate on this one. Gloria is walking along a path joining these two points, while Suresh is walking along the path joining 0, 5 and 4, 0. So these are two coordinate points. These are two coordinate points. We'll put a point and make a straight line. And that is how the situation can be shown graphically. So the first point is minus 2, 3. X is minus 2, that is you are coming here. And Y is 3. So Y is 3 here. 1, 2, 3. That means somewhere here this point is there. One is this point. And 2 and minus 2. X is 2. So X is 2. And Y is minus 2. This one. So you have a point here. So make a line. And then next one is 0, 5 and 4, 0. So you have X is 0. That is Y axis is 5. Y is 0, X is 4. So this one is the point. Now you make a line. And you see that these two lines are parallel lines. They are walking parallelly. This is how we can show it on graph. On comparing the ratio A1 by B1 or A1 by A2. We have already done in the previous questions. So A1 by A2, B1 by B2, C1 by C2. You don't have to draw the line. You just have to say by these ratio that these lines represent either intersecting line, coincident line, or parallel line. So first let me tell you that in this equation, this first equation, this is A1, this is B1, and this is C1. You have to take the signs also, right? This is A2, this is B2, and this is C2. So now we will take A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, take the ratio. So when you take ratio of this 5 by 7 by minus 4 by 6 and by 8 by minus 9. So here A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. See here. That is not equal to C1 by C2 either. That means these two lines will be intersecting. They will give you some result. Because they are not parallel. Parallel line never intersect. But the lines where A1, A2, B1, B2, C1, C2 ratio are not equal, that means they are going to intersect somewhere. So you will get a solution. When you come here, A1, A2, B1, B2, C1, C2. Just take the ratio. You see A1 by A2 is half, B1 by B2 is half. That means these two lines are parallel. Now again we come to C1 by C2 and we see C1 by C2 is also equal. That means if you say one line is this, other line is also this, that means they are coincident line, they are same line. Because A1 by A2, B1 by B2, C1 by C2 are same. Let us come here, 6 by 2 equal to 3 by 1 minus 1, minus 3 by minus 1 equal to 10 by 9. Let us see what goes here. This is 6 by 2, that is 3. This is also 3. So A1 by A2 and B1 by B2 are equal. But they are not equal to 10 by 9, that is C1 by C2. So A1 by A2 and B1 by B2 are equal. That means, or if it this C1 by C2 is not equal, that is they are not coincident, but still A1 by A2 and B1 by B2 means they are parallel. They are parallel, they are not going to intersect anywhere. Given the equation 2x plus 3y minus 8, write linear equation, geometric representation of the pair saying they are intersecting, parallel and coincident. So what we have tried here is this is our initial equation, right? 2x plus 3y minus 8. Now we have taken an arbitrary equation so that this a1 by a2 and b1, first we have to find out the intersecting line. So that a1 by a2, b1 by b2 and c1 by c2 are not equal. Essentially, a1 by a2 and b1 by b2 should not be equal. So we have chosen a line like 4x plus 9y minus 4. This was just done because we wanted these two ratios not to be equal. You take any ratio, you take any line, whose a1 by a2 and b1 by b2 should not be equal. So this is an equation which we choose, and they are actually intersecting. But when we take an equation like 4x plus 6y minus 4, and when we take a1 by a2, b1 by b2, c1 by c2, so a1 by a2 and b1 by b2 are equal, right? And c1 by c2 is not equal to them. That means these are lines parallel to each other. Now we can take any line where a1 by a2, b1 by b2 and c1 by c2 are equal. If these three are equal, if these three are same, that means we are taking, or we are saying that these are coincident lines. How to do that? If you have 2x plus 3y minus 8, just multiply it by any number. Any number which comes in your mind, multiply it. If I am multiplying it by, say, 3, it will be 6x plus 3 is a 9y minus 8 is a 24 equal to 0. So this line and this line, these are coincident, because I am just multiplying it with common factor, any common factor with this line. And if I take, say, 2 by 6, and then with 3 by 9, and then I take 8 by 24, see, 2 3s are 6, 1 by 3, 3 3s are 9, 1 by 3, 8 3s are 24, 1 by 3, all 3 are equal. That means these two lines, this one and this one, they are coincident. The cost of 2 kg apples and 1 kg of grapes was found to be 160. So if I say x is the cost of apples, so 2 into x plus 1 kg, 1 into grapes is y, equal to 160. Now after a month, the cost of 4 kg apple, now the 4 kg apple is there, so 4x is the cost of apple, and 2 kg of grapes, so 2 into y is the cost of 1 kg of grapes, so 2 into y, now the cost is 300. So these are our two equations. Represent them algebraically and geometrically. So we have one equation like this, 2x plus y, because x we have taken as 1 kg apple, y is the cost of 1 kg of grape, and 2x plus y equal to 160, 4x plus 2y equal to 300. This is what we got. Now, as I said earlier also, you can represent this in this form, y equal to 160 minus 2x. And this has y equal to 300, take it here, minus 4x, and divide it by 2. Now just put x equal to 50. What do you get? 5 to the 10, 100, 160 minus 100 is 60. For x, 50, y is 60. Now put x equal to 60, 6 to the 12, 120, 160 minus 120 is 40. So for x equal to 60, y is 40. We are good with this. We just need two points. Here let us put x equal to, say, 7, 7 4 is 28, 300 minus 280 is 20, 20 by 2 is 10, 1 point. Now put 4x equal to 8, so 8 4s are 32, 300 minus 320 is minus 20, minus 20 by 2 is minus 10. So just point these, you know, you will get the graph. So see, x 60, we have to point 50, 60, so x is 50, y is 60, no, x is 50, y is 60, so x is 50, y is 60. That means this is 1 point. This is 1 point. And x is 60, y is 40. So x is 60, y is 40. These are 2 points. Just make a line. Now here, x is 70, y is 10. So x is 70, y is 10. This is 1 point. This one. And then we have x is 80, y is minus 10. So x is 80, this one. And y is 10. So this is another point. Make a line. They are parallel lines.